Hi, this is Simon, and I'm probably going to get flamed in the comments for my Shakuhachi playing, but this is part four of our introduction to pure data. In this lesson, we're going to be looking at audio, DSP, getting sound out of pure data itself. Up until this point, we've been sending MIDI information to external instruments and then using those for our sound output. Now we're going to make everything inside of PD. In order to accomplish this, we're going to be using an object called a DAC. DAC stands for Digital Analog Converter. This is what allows us to send audio output. You'll notice it has two inputs, a left and a right, for our speakers. So let's send something to this. I'm going to create another object, OSC, for oscillator. This is a sine wave oscillator. I'm going to tell it to oscillate at 440 hertz. Wire this up. Now, this is all set to go to my output, but I haven't started my DSP yet in this window. What I'm going to do before I do that, because this will probably be very loud, I'm going to turn down on my mixer, which you can't see. And there's our signal. I'm going to turn that back down. In addition to the sine wave oscillator, there's also a sawtooth oscillator that we can call on with phasor. Turn it on, turn it up. And there's also a noise, which is white noise. You'll notice that all of the objects I'm using are going to have this tilde after them, and that's how you know that they're doing DSP, that digital signal processing. Let's go back to our oscillator. And again, it needs an argument for the frequency. As I said, this is probably too loud, so I can actually reduce its volume, its amplitude, by going command 1, multiply tilde. Again, this is a multiplication, but because it's got a tilde after it, I'm multiplying that signal, 0.1. So this will bring that signal down to be much quieter, 1/10 the amplitude, much more manageable. I could create some control for this oscillator. I could take a note in. Again, this is getting the MIDI information from my keyboard. And so if I just play on my keyboard, we can see numbers coming in here. These are MIDI note numbers that I'm playing though, and my oscillator wants a frequency. So what I'll do is I'll add M2F, MIDI to frequency. So this object does that conversion for me, so I don't have to do the math. And now let's hear it. Not bad. Instead of getting note in from the keyboard, though, I could do our usual thing. Toggle, command 1, metro 200. Use this metro to create a random number between 0 and 87. To that number, I'll add 21. And the reason I'm choosing these numbers is a piano has 88 keys, and the lowest key on the keyboard is 21. So now, let's listen to this. Not bad. You'll notice I turned up the DSP, but my metro's still going. I can turn back the DSP. And then if I stop the metro, the oscillator is still going. The only thing that stopped is the random selection of numbers for the pitches. So in order to stop that, I need to turn off the DSP here. Okay, this is an interesting start. But we could do something a little bit more interesting with this, and we could take it and ring modulate it. So I can just duplicate all of this. In order to do a ring modulation, all we're doing is multiplying two signals together. So I could take this oscillator and multiply it by this oscillator. So I'm just going to detach these wires here, attach this up, start up both these metros. Could be more interesting if I have one metro running two sets of random numbers here. That way they're in sync. That's kind of nice. Should be faster though. Okay, that's not bad. Let's send this information somewhere. So instead of sending data, I'm going to send an audio signal. So now I have an S with a tilde after it. I'm going to send this to a place I'll call delay. So now I need to just receive on that delay. And let's create a little delay effect. In order to do that, I'm going to need to make a buffer that the delays can work on. Del write. So this is going to write that information into the buffer. Let's call that just del buff. That name is arbitrary. I've just made that up. And then let's do a delay time of 210 milliseconds. This didn't work because I forgot to put my tilde for audio. So this is writing all of that information into that delay buffer. In order to make a delay, I need to read back out of that delay buffer. So there's my delay read. It's usually good to take your delayed signal and reduce it. I'm turning that down. I'm also going to add a low pass filter. And then we'll send this output. Receive on that output into my DAC. So now we're getting each note sounding twice. It gets sent to the DAC, but then it also gets sent to the delay, which writes it to a delay buffer and then reads from that delay buffer. It's going to sound 210 milliseconds later at a slightly lower volume. I could take this output, though, and send it back into the delay to do a feedback. That's actually quite nice. So here's the patch that I had running at the beginning of the video. First, this is our sequencer. To this point where we have the make note, this all looks familiar to what we've been doing in MIDI. From here, I do something slightly different. After the make note, I convert that MIDI to a frequency and then send it to my sawtooth oscillator. Here, make note sends out a velocity. Velocity is 0 to 127. So I divide that by 127 to get a number 0 to 1 that I can multiply my signal by to attenuate it. The trick here is that when a note starts, make note sends this velocity that we've sent out here, and when a note ends, it sends a velocity of 0. So if a velocity is 0 divided by 127 is still 0, that's going to silence our notes coming out of the phasor too. Finally, I have an ADC here. Remember, we used the DAC before, which is our digital to analog converter. This is an analog to digital converter. So what this does is this takes the microphone input. I send the microphone input out to the DAC. I send my sequence notes out to the DAC, but also I send both to my delay write buffer here. The buffer is written here. It's read from over here. Again, I reduce the amplitude. Send to the low pass filter, and then I send that out to the output. I also send it to feedback. Feedback goes here and then goes back into the delay write giving me a traditional feedback delay sound.